Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today, I was going to make a big apple pie. I've got some ambrosia apples here that I need to use up. They're pretty bruised, kind of on their last legs, so I thought I'd make a pie. And then I thought, there's just two of us, we're in a lockdown, why don't I make individual pies or smaller pies so that I can freeze some, and then we don't have a giant pie sitting on the counter calling to us to eat it. So, start by peeling the apples, and you could use a peeler, you could use a paring knife like I'm doing. So many ways to peel an apple. Do the way that makes you feel comfortable. And for the most part, I think of apple pies as being fairly free form. Every apple is going to taste different, going to need a different amount of sugar, going to need a different amount of spicing, and you sort of have to play it by ear depending on what apples you get. And as much as everybody says, you know, oh, you should use this type of apple, not every type of apple is available everywhere all the time. This ambrosia apple that I'm using is available across North America fairly easily, I believe. It's grown pretty much everywhere in North America at this point. But it's not always going to be at the grocery store. It's not always going to be at the market. So you have to kind of play it by ear when you're working with apples. And not every apple is going to be the same size. You're sometimes going to have to cut around bad parts. So you need to be flexible when you're doing this. And don't really worry too much about it. It'll often turn out just fine. So I've got a lot of apples. I should shut up and just keep peeling. Okay, last few slices, and I've chopped these up finer than I would for a regular pie. Just because I'm putting them in the smaller pie shells, you can pack more apple in if they're sliced a little bit finer. And so my jug is full. I ended up doing 8 apples, which gives me 8 cups of apple bits, and we'll see where that gets us when we start filling up the pies. So these ambrosia apples are really sweet, so I'm not going to use too much sugar. I'm only going to use about 2 teaspoons of sugar for each apple. I'm also going to put in cinnamon, and I'm going to grate in some nutmeg. Kind of the classic apple pie flavors. And so we'll just mix that together, get the cinnamon and the sugar and the nutmeg mixed together. I'm going to put this into the apples, and then I'm going to let the apples macerate overnight. I'm going to put a cover on this, stick it in the fridge. I'll probably stir it up 3 or 4 times over the course of the next 24 hours. These could stay in the fridge for 3 days before you actually make the pie, just soaking in the sugar, releasing juices, and they will be absolutely fine. And this maceration step is something that I learned in the 90s working on a TV commercial. I forget what the ad was, but it was a family in a park having a picnic. And so the food stylist made these apple pies to be in the shot, beautiful apple pies, by macerating the apples. And so what's going to happen is the sugar is going to start drawing moisture out of the apples. And we'll drain that moisture off and we'll cook it separately. And what this does is it keeps the apples from breaking down as much when they're baking in the pie. So they keep their shape much better and you don't get a runny pie. You get a really nice, full, stiff pie. And after I started collecting cookbooks, I started to realize that this procedure was in place in a lot of cookbooks in the 1800s and the 1700s. And in the 1700s, even farther back into the 1600s, I have cookbooks that show them stewing the apples first, not to the point where they're mush, where they are, not to the point where they've turned into applesauce, but just enough to pre-cook them, drive off some of the moisture, and then they react better in a pie later. So these are going to go into the fridge, and we'll come back tomorrow and put together the pies. A full day has gone by, and these apples have macerated. They've given up quite a bit of liquid in the bottom. But the apples themselves still remain really crispy. And I think I've got the right amount of sugar and cinnamon and nutmeg on them. Taste them at this point. No sense putting them into a pie if they don't taste right now. And this is a point where you could adjust that sweetness and all of the other flavors. So what I'm going to do is drain this apple liquid out of the bottom of the jug and try not to get too many apples into the pot. And yeah, you could run it through a colander or a strainer and not get any apple pieces in the pot. It's not the way I roll. So I'm going to pull those two pieces out. Got about 3/4 cup of liquid, maybe almost a cup of apple liquid. I'm going to put this on a fairly gentle heat. I don't want to boil it too hard. I don't want to thicken it too much, but I do want to reduce it and thicken it a little bit. And while that's going, we will go ahead and start rolling out our pastry. And I'm using an all butter crust today for no particular reason. I just kind of like it with apple pie. You could use lard, you could use any sort of vegetable shortening that you like. And just kind of roll it out and we'll start lining the pastry tins. Okay, I think I've got this rolled out far enough that I can get 6 bottoms for these tins. And I know that this is the right size to follow as a pattern or a guide. So let's see. Drop that in. There we go. I'll keep these in the fridge. I've got the lids rolled out and cut, and this syrup has reduced down to, I'd say, less than 1/3 cup, maybe 1/3 to 1/4 cup. So we're gonna fill the cases at this point with the apples. And you can really pile the apples in. Really pile them in. Okay, so there's a win. 8 apples or 8 cups of chopped apple fills 6 of these cases. So the next thing we're gonna do is take this apple syrup and drizzle a little bit in each one. So thick and apple-y, look at that. Put a little piece of butter on the top of each one. And then give just a little bit of an egg wash around the rim before we put the lid on. Come in with the lid. 2 of these pies I'm going to bake right now for supper tonight. So I'm going to put an egg wash on the outside and then sprinkle them with a little bit of sugar. The other 4 are going to go right into the freezer, and I'm going to freeze them solid. And once they're frozen, I'm going to wrap them up either in some saran wrap or maybe vacuum seal them. And they will stay in the fridge until I want to cook them. And depending on how well you wrap them, they can stay in the fridge for months if you can resist not eating them for that long. And then I'll just bake them from frozen, put them right into a preheated 425 or 450 degree oven, and bake them until they're cooked. So, into the oven with these 2, into the freezer with those 4.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends, more pie, I'll get forks.
Apple pie.
I see you put some granular sugar on top there.
A little bit of sugar on top, give it a little bit of, make it special. Ooh. It's pretty good, Jules, I'm kind of happy with that. Okay, so, there's no graceful way.
To be tiny little.
To take a tiny little pie. It's pretty much, you take the little pie, you put it on a plate, and you sit down and you eat the pie. Those apples are great.
That's a little bit too, I'm just gonna eat it like a sandwich. No, I'm not.
Maybe I will. Yep.
Those apples are great. I really like those. I'd kind of forgotten about them as that particular type of apple. Ambrosia.
Mmm, those are tasty.
Yeah. So tiny little pies are great because now we've got them in the freezer, and after supper you go, oh, I wish we had something for dessert. You just pull them out, slide them into the oven, and they're done. You just cook them from frozen.
They are. Eventually, though, they do disappear.
Well, yeah, because you've eaten them. Then you have to make more, and you could make a different kind of fruit. So, and I get it. You might not want to make tiny little pies. You want to make a big pie, but you just take the method that I did here with the macerating and the crust and the whole deal. Just make a big pie. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon. Yeah.